spawning fresh if only a rock in your hand. You've got to compete for every bit of resource you can possibly get your hands on, all while trying to avoid those that have what you want. How can you possibly do this in the most simple way possible? By building a starter that provides you with everything you need. This is my answer to that question indeed. The Hermes, the expanded version of the wet dream. It gives you everything you need from day one. Speed and agility at its core. Featuring one of Rasma's versatile and robust bunker starters capable of holding any deployable you might need early game, it quickly expands to feature 24 large boxes of storage, all protected by two auto turrets. Finally, to ward off any online raids, it offers a simplistic, easy to build shooting floor. Couple this with 10 quick spawn locations and it's sure to ward off any online raids. In total, it offers 27 rockets of protection to TC and 36 the remainder of the loot. All of this at a measly cost of 3k wood, 47k stone, 30k metal and 380 HQM, I'm sure this will make you wipe worth playing. Now for a quick base tour. Starting off the tour, we enter one of our two disconnectable mini-story TCs. As you can see, quite a low upkeep, easy to maintain. To disconnect, simply drop a square foundation and roof piece, and the roof frame will be broken. Now we enter through one of our two quick spawn airlocks. Featuring two beds and an airlock, this is quick hitting at its finest. Continuing on our compound tour, we can see our chain link splitting our compound into two. Entering another variety of an airlock, this gives great visuals while offering full head protection. Now doing a full loop, we'll see one of each of our airlocks again. Entering the base for a single airlock with a hatch. As we enter, we can see a research bench with a drop box, protected by an auto turret and a locker for quick cutting. As we open the garage doors, it reveals our open core looting room and a second turret for protection. Now to reveal one of our two open core loot room wings, featuring a total of 12 large boxes of storage. Our second featuring our level 3 and a large battery in the corner. Now, as you can see, a bunkered starter. To open this, simply dive right on in and remove this twig frame wall. Now, this will open the bunker and jump right on in. Jumping down and opening the garage doors, we see our refinery and some storage, followed by a level 2 workbench. Safely tucked away in the corner is our TC and two small boxes, followed by a furnace. Opening up the TC, we see our upkeep. Now continuing up our chute to the third floor. We find our first mixing table with some more storage, safely tucked away in the corner. As you can see, this floor is protected by an auto turret. It also features another spawn location with two beds and a locker. Now proceeding up to the shooting floor. The shooting floor contains another spawning location with two beds and a locker. And a mixing table. This can easily be adapted to fit two. Now for a quick look around the shooting floor. These are some of my favorite peaks, as the amount of online raiders that have wasted clips and trying to shoot through these are great. Simply open the door and fire back when you're ready. Moving up to the final floor, the roof. This can either be a vending machine to sell any unwanted goods or additional storage. The roof offers great peaks. Let's begin this build with the music it deserves. To start the build, simply drop down a low triangle foundation, wall it all in. This will fit your TC and your furnace. Now drop a raised furnace and seal everything in as follows. Got to think of this slightly different, as your triangle is your main base and the square foundation is your airlock, but feel free to drop anything you might need before expanding inside the triangle. Just keep your valuables inside the lock compartment. Moving on to stage 2, this is the bunker, built as followed. Now to start the bunker, simply drop down a triangle foundation, followed by a square foundation, and build 9 triangles off of the left, as followed. Cap this with a square foundation. As you can see, 9 triangles, delete your build up. Now build back at the base and cap it off with a triangle. The triangle is extremely important and build as followed. As you can see, I've placed it wrong because the rocks are on the right side. Simply place this again and ensure the rocks are on your left side. This means you can upgrade this to stone and you're good for stage 2 of the bunker build out. Now delete your build up and build out 9 triangle foundations again, capping it off with a square foundation. Now delete your build up. Big shout out to the God Bunker video linked in the description. Build back with square foundations, make sure your square connects to your build out, place a wall onto the build out. Now ensure you drop the roof from the outside. The roof should have 31 stability. If it does, simply upgrade that and the wall and place down your second roof tile. This should have 11 stability. Upgrade it if it does. Now you'll see the bunker can't seal. To seal it, drop down a doorway frame, leave this twig, and now it can be sealed. To open up the bunker, simply remove the twig. Simple bunker, I absolutely love it. Now feel free to remove the twig foundation for your refinery. The walls are self-supporting, so you don't actually need those triangle foundations just yet. Now seal yourself in. When you're done sealing yourself in, simply build an airlock as followed. For a simple jump up, just drop down a triangle foundation, upgrade it if you'd like, followed by a twig triangle roof and a lower triangle foundation. Now for all your deployables. When you've got your tier 2 workbench, simply do the following. time to build your honeycombing and your level 2. I prefer to keep the next foundation high as it protects the other square foundation. I'll build the following out as such. As you can see, we don't have a foundation, so you'll need to build this all for the right one. When building the god bunker, ensure you don't connect back onto it, as this will cause issues later on in the build, as it will show. Now to place walls and seal it all in. Don't place this low wall until you've either dropped a large battery or a locker inside, as you won't be able to drop it afterwards. As you can see, I can't drop this frame as it's built off the god bunker. This is a warning. This can be spread to other frames, making your build far more difficult. Now for all the deployables, this is how I like to kit it out, but feel free to customize it to your own desire and your own needs, as every player plays differently. The only way to drop these lockers is to jump down inside, go to the back and drop it in. Once this is done, you've got a suicide, so make sure you only have the locker in your hands, as you won't be able to retrieve it later without breaking the locker. The battery, however, is far more simple. I like to drop my electric furnaces on the top shelf as shown in the tour, but you be you. Time to build level 3. Leave the top triangle wood, as you will be destroying this later to build your roof access. Time for level 3 deployables. For the compound, you can either build it directly into your base as shown at the start of this, or you can use external TCs. I highly recommend external TCs as this will ensure if your base is raided they can't take it over, because your TCs will kick in and prevent them from gaining privilege. As you see, I can't drop the TC. This is because it is directly connected into the base. As stated, you don't need the external TCs, but it is highly recommended. If you are going to build an external TC, remember not to upgrade this triangle foundation and these two frames, because you will need to remove them to drop down the TC. As mentioned, if you don't want external TC, simply reconnect your external as follows. As you can see, you can't connect directly to the base because you do have the external TC down. If you want to reconnect, simply destroy the external TC or don't place it to start with. I personally find two external TCs to be plenty on vanilla servers, so I only have two externals. If you want four, just build it as shown previously. Thank you. Feel free to build the same external gatehouse if you like, I just like the two varieties. Now for the final gatehouse. Now that the gatehouses are complete, it's time to drop the walls. These can either be stone or wood, you choose which preference you prefer. When dropping walls, I prefer to use the arrows created by the gatehouses. Now remember, when dropping walls, close enough is good enough. As long as it works, it does the job, you know what I'm saying? Thank you. so I like to set out the compound, but feel free to do your own thing. Just remember, the more furnaces you drop, the easier it is for someone to hide from the turrets. Now let's build a shooting floor. Feel free just to drop down a normal window if you don't want the chain link shootbacks, but I think they're a great asset to the build and highly recommend using them. You can either drop one mixing table or two if you'd like. I prefer just using one unless I am cooking some serious GP. With this windmill being dropped, that's the end of the video. Thanks for anyone that made it this far, I really appreciate it. And if you've got any comments, any feedbacks, any design changes you would do, let me know, because it really does help, and it will only increase the build's potential, lethality, and defensibility. So feel free to watch on. I just merely show what my favorite upgrades are you can make, high qual, metal, etc, and a few bits and other bits and pieces. But yeah, stay tuned, because the quad version of this base, trio quad, will be coming out shortly, featuring two bunkers. I'm currently working, serving a third and a third, and I'm also editing two videos of live actual gameplay. I think those will be really interesting, so I suggest you stick around and watch. And if you don't, thanks for giving it a watch anyway. Have a good day, have a good night, whatever you are, you're awesome. Stay awesome. That's all I can say. Thanks for anyone who made it this far. You're awesome. Stay cool and never feel bad.